Hi everyone, Ashley here and welcome to another video on my YouTube channel. Today I'm going to share how I made this fun tropical themed card using some of Lawn Fawn's newest release supplies as part of their June 2021 release. And that would be this tropical frame background die and some of the cute jungle themed stamps from their Toucan Do It stamp set. So without further ado, let's get into it. I'm starting by blending the background panel, and for this I'm using four colors of Distress Oxide ink. The first is Peacock Feathers, the second is Picked Raspberry, the third, which is orange, is Dried Marigold, and the final one is Mustard Seed, which is that yellow. And I'm just blending them on in sort of horizontal lines to get this sort of ombre effect, and going back and forth between the colors to make sure that the blend is nice. And I really love this color combination for like bright tropical backgrounds because it's just very vibrant and very sort of, in my opinion, the colors are very tropical with those sort of bright pinks and oranges. And I love that purple that you get from blending the pink and the blue, which is really pretty. So to get this background looking really shiny, I'm just spraying on a layer of Avery Elle Clear Shimmer Spray. I sprayed that kind of from off camera, and now you can see as I turn this panel in the light how you get that beautiful sort of subtle shimmer effect in the background, which is really pretty. Now I'm going on to that tropical frame, and I've cut this out from a piece of turquoise cardstock. This is a piece of cardstock that came in one of the Lawn Fawn rainbow paper packs, so I'm not exactly sure what the name of this particular cardstock is, but I would have to guess it's probably mermaid or merman or something. I think that's their two colors of turquoise paper and ink, so it's one of those. And I'm just blending on little spots of color, so I used Lucky Clover and Twisted Citron Distress Oxide inks. And I'm just sort of blending them on in little patches, kind of to create this multicolor effect, which is really nice because, you know, the main shape of it is that turquoise from the paper, but then you get these added little splotches of color, which make it look almost like watercolor or blended when it wasn't really. So that's always a fun and easy effect to get that kind of cool look on a background. And I actually learned that from watching one of the intro videos to these products by, I think, Kelly Marie as part of the Lawn Fawn team. So if you go over to the Lawn Fawn YouTube channel, you'll see a bunch of intro videos for their products. You can get some good ideas of how to use them. And that was one idea from a card that was made in one of those videos that I thought was really good. So I was happy to try it out on my own. Next, I stamped out a whole bunch of images from that Toucan Do It stamp set. This is one of, again, their newest release stamp sets, which has these two jaguars, a couple toucans, and then a few other little bits and bobs, so like a little lizard, which is so cute, a couple butterflies, some flowers, and some branches. So I just stamped out a few of the images, and I'm just coloring them in with my Copic markers. I will say I did stamp them in my mini Misty tool, which is always good for double stamping. It gets a really nice, crisp black image by being able to stamp things twice in the same spot. And I stamped them with my Gina K Amalgam ink, which from some testing I've done lately, I've found to be the most solid black ink for Copic coloring. It seems to smear with the Copic markers the least from the inks I've tried. So if you do find an issue with Copic marker smearing as you color in black stamped images, I would definitely recommend trying out that Gina K Amalgam ink if you haven't already. And I do hope it works a little bit better for you. I also stamped out these images onto some Neenah Solar White cardstock, which is a really nice cardstock for Copic coloring and blending. And now I'm just coloring them in with my Copic markers. I'm going to show you sort of how I colored the main images and leave sort of the smaller images out, just so you can kind of get an idea of how I color. But I do color most images the same way, which is that I start with my darkest shade and then I blend it out with lighter shades. Sometimes two, sometimes three, depending on the image and the size of the image. So for small images, I usually just use two shades. For bigger images, I often use three. And then I just sort of place the dark shade where I think there should be shadow, and then I blend it out to the areas where I think there would be light hitting it using the lighter shades. So I'm doing that with the toucans here using some cool gray markers. I started with C7, and then my lighter shades are C5 and C3. I'm just using some sort of tropical colors to fill in the rest of the parts of the images as well. So those same sort of colors I used on the background, some pinks, some blues, and some oranges and yellows, which I think is just such a nice tropical color scheme. I'm going to go ahead and put on some background music as I finish up with this coloring so you can sit back, relax, and enjoy the coloring. If you do want to just skip ahead to see the rest of the card coming together, of course feel free to do that as well. We'll be right back. Okay, so now that the coloring is done and I've gone ahead and cut out those images off camera, it's time to put together the sentiment. And for this, I'm stamping out one of the sentiments from the stamp set, which is Have a Wild Day, onto some black cardstock because I'm going to white heat emboss it. So I went over that cardstock first with my powder bag, which just helps to avoid some static. And then I'm just pouring on some white embossing powder onto a coffee filter, which I can then just pour the excess back into the little jar. Off camera, I did melt that with my heat tool, and you can see it came out to say, Have a Wild Day, with some nice crisp white embossing, which is nice. Now to put this card together, I'm first just gluing that background, that blended piece, onto a card base. By the way, this is just a standard size card. It's 4.25 by 5.5 inches. And then I can just glue this tropical frame right on top. And I just sort of did a line of liquid glue around the edge, and now I'm putting little dots of liquid glue on all those leaves, except for the ones that I know I want to tuck things behind. So I kind of had an idea of what layout I wanted, and I knew I wanted to tuck a few things behind some of the leaves, so I left glue off of those for now. So for example, I put that branch behind one of the leaves, and I'm going to be tucking this little jaguar behind the bottom leaves as well. For any leaves that I realized I probably could have used a bit more glue, of course you can just go around after and just add a little bit of glue behind the leaf and stick it down and hold it down for a moment until it sticks. And that will kind of help get everything nice and flat too. So then I can start just arranging all of these elements onto the card in a way that I think is cute. So I put the standing jaguar down at the bottom with a little lizard on his back. And then I put the sitting jaguar on a branch and another one of the toucans on another branch near the top. And then I can kind of just go through and glue all of these elements down. I used a combination of liquid glue and foam squares. So for some elements, I popped them up. And for some elements, I just glued them right down. I knew I wanted that sentiment strip to be glued straight down, sort of sitting behind the jaguar, so I glued that down first. Then I glued down the branch that the jaguar will sit on, and then I can put some foam squares behind that jaguar and tape him or her down onto the branch, sitting right above that sentiment banner, which I think is nice. Then I can just continue to go through and glue down all of the rest of the pieces until all of the elements are glued down onto the card. I really like I mentioned a few times now, I love how the color combination is tropical, but I also love how it kind of looks like a sunset. So it looks like the sun is sort of setting and you're getting those beautiful blue colors in the background. I stimped off the edge of the sentiment banner that was overhanging, and then I can just come in and add a few more little images throughout the card. And that is it. That is the card for today. I really love that shimmery background that came through with that clear shimmer spray. It's really pretty in real life. I'm trying to give you an idea of how pretty it is by turning that card in the light. But I just love these new tropical products as well. So this is such a fun card to make, and I hope you enjoyed watching. So thank you so much for sticking around and watching. If you do like watching these videos, do check out the other ones I have up on my channel. And check out my other cards that I post on my Instagram account, which is linked down in the description below. I hope you have a great day, and I will see you again soon. Bye!